The predicament of humanity is that at any given moment in time, with the existing technology that you have, you face a finite world of natural resources, except that what you can use as a natural resource is already defined by the technology you have. So if you expand your technological repertoire and armory through scientific discovery and technological development, you can define increasing areas of the natural world as usable natural resources. And that's what we've done up to now. If wood is not enough, get coal. If coal is not convenient, get oil. If oil is not enough, get nuclear. If nuclear has problems, get thermonuclear. Look at antimatter. Look beyond, and still beyond, beyond a horizon that we can't even see at this point. Science, technology, and industry can solve any problem with political will and the proper effort. And that's pretty much how humanity has survived up to now. But with the right kind of national mobilization, technology, and political will, you can do just about anything, including putting a man on the moon or putting other people out into space. If you look in historians of world history, like Toynbee, he's got a catalog of, what, 20 different world civilizations, and they've all collapsed except one. And generally, they've collapsed from within, and they've collapsed to a very significant degree because of thinking like this, that there's a limit to growth and that the privileges of an oligarchy are more important than the standard of living and the success of the individual human families. The essential human condition is realize progress or collapse. Advance in science, technology, and industry, or you will soon cease to exist. And that's the fundamental human premise